पितामह मे भवदीय सम्मतः। प्रह्राद आविष्कृत साधुवादः भवद् विपक्षेन विचित्र वैशशम् संप्रापितस्त्वं परमास पित्रा। My grandfather Prahlad Maharaj is famous, being recognized by all your devotees. Although harassed in many ways by his father Hiranyakashipu, he still remained faithful, taking shelter at your lotus feet. So today's discussion is about Prahlad Maharaj. And what did Prahlad Maharaj do? Prahlad Maharaj was just chanting. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. He was thinking about all the time about Krishna or Narasimha. That's all. And what did Hiranyakashipu do? He stood like this, you know, lifting on his toes. Unimaginable hard work. Very painful. And for a long time. And ants came and started eating his body. He did not move. His whole body was eaten up by the ants. Still, he did not give up his determination. And he was doing so much pain, so much hard work, so much difficulty to get some material boon. At the end, everything was smashed. Everything was taken away. And what did Prahlad Maharaj do? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And what is the result? He became so dear to Krishna. And his grandson, Bali Maharaj, is taking great pride. What a grandfather I had. My grandfather is worshipped even by devatas. If ever they take an example of a devotee, they first remember Prahlad Maharaj. And Narasimhadeva told Prahlad Maharaj that 21 generations before you have delivered. So to become a devotee of the Lord is a great choice. And it's very easy. Just chant Hare Krishna. Think about Krishna. But for material enjoyment, we do so much hard work. We take so much anxiety for material hard work. Okay. That is very unfortunate. So Prahlad Maharaj did not give up the lotus feet of Narasimhadeva. Even though his father said, if you continue chanting, I'll kill you. Not only he said he will kill you, actually tried to kill him in so many times. And finally, one day Narasimhadeva came and killed his father. So this whole pastime, Prahlad Maharaj, is so sweet. So for today, I just taken 4 instructions of Prahlad Maharaj, which he gave to his father. Even though Prahlad Maharaj had more realizations than his father, he never lost his etiquettes. He was very cultured. Just like Bali Maharaj had more knowledge than Shukracharya. But he was always very polite to Shukracharya. So devotee is faultless. Sometimes it does happen. We know something which our elder may not know. But we maintain our culture. So we get a very good example from Prahlad Maharaj. Whenever he came to meet his father, he gave full obeisances. He gave him all respect due to a father. But he did not give up the spiritual knowledge. And with great mercy and affection, he tried to save even his father. Okay? So let us take four instructions which he gave to his father, and his father did not listen. Okay? This is the first time when Hiranyakashipu calls Prahlad when he's a 5-year-old boy, and he asked him, "My dear son, what is the best thing you've learned in your Gurukul?" Shanda and Amarka were training him. He wanted to know, what is the best thing you learned? So Prahlad Maharaj says, Tata sadhu manye asuravarya dehinam sada samudvigna dhiyam asat graha hitva tapatam griya andakupam vanam gato yan harimashayeta. Very beautiful line. What does it mean? It means this. Prahlad Maharaj said, Tata sadhu manye asuravarya dehinam. He says, "Oh, best of the asuras." He doesn't say, "My dear father." "Oh, best of the asuras." But he's happy. Hiranyakashipu is very happy. "Oh, best of the asuras." Sada samudvigna dhiyam asat grahat. Everybody is in so much anxiety. Dhiyam asat grahat. Why everybody is in anxiety? Because they have asat grahat. They accepted a temporary place as their home. Griha means home. So everybody wants to make their home, which is temporary. Hitva tapatam griham andakupam. They have given a place for spiritual culture. And they have jumped into a blind well of suffering. Andakupa. Vanam gato. My dear father, in this situation, it is best. Vanam gato, go to vana means Vrindavana. And Harimashreya, take shelter of Hari. So his father was very happy. He was very happy. He was angry. Harimashreya. What is this Hariashreya? Like Ravana, you tell, Ramashreya. He's not going to accept. So he was not happy. He was extremely angry. He had taken the child with so much love, but now he was very angry. So he told, but still, this time he did not take any action. He sent the child away. He told Shanda and Amarka, "Take care. Somebody looks to be spoiling his head." Just like most of the parents today. If the child is saying, chanting Hare Krishna, they think he is wasting his time. They don't understand the value. They are mostly like Hiranyakashipu. Modern day education is also like Shanda and Amarka education. So next, what happens? Shanda and Amarka in the so-called Gurukul, they start scolding Prahlad Maharaj. And they teach so much nonsense. Prahlad Maharaj is not happy. What not? They are telling, enemy, your enemy, your enemy, Vishnu. Prahlad Maharaj's heart is so great, he cannot think of an enemy. He has no enemy. He is a well-wisher of the whole world. Ajata Shatrava Shantaha Sadhava Sadhu Bhushanam. He has all the qualities of a sadhu. Titikshava Karunikaha Suhrida Sarvabhutanam Ajata Shatrava Shanta Sadhava Sadhu Bhushanam. You know the shloka? Yeah. Ajata Shatra, he is no enemy. He is only thinking well. And they are telling, enemy, enemy. He is not enemy. Why enemy? He is thinking, why enemy? So he is not happy. And then finally, anyway, they instruct him for a few months, say 6 months. They try to brainwash him. This small boy. And they bring him back to to Hiranyakashipu. We have brainwashed him fully. So again, Hiranyakashipu asks, okay, tell me, what did you learn in the Gurukul? He is expecting what the child will say, 5 plus 5 is 10, something like that he will tell. But Prahlad Maharaj is one of the greatest acharyas in the history. So he pays obeisances to his father, and with great love and affection for the father, again instructs his father. And what is the instruction? Shanavata Shavanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasyam Sakyam Atmanivedanam Itim Pumsar Pita Vishnu Bhaktisce Navalakshana Kriyeta Bhagavati Adda Tanmanni Aditam Uttamam. So this is it. He says, these 9 ways we can serve Vishnu. What are the 9 ways? Shravanam. We can always hear about. That's the easy thing. We do japa and we can hear about Krishna. Kirtana. After hearing, we can speak. Smarana. We can think about. Pada Sevanam. We can worship the lotus feet. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu. Smaranam Pada Sevanam. Archanam, we can worship. Vandanam, we can offer prayers. Dasyam, we can become a servant. Sakyam, we can become friend. And Atmanivedanam, we can totally surrender. The first 3 are Bhagavad Vidhi. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam. Bhagavad Vidhi. The next 4 are Pancharatrika Vidhi. Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam. And Sakyam and Atma Nivedanam is Raganuga Bhakti. Okay. So there he is saying, my Lord, there are 9 ways we can serve you. So Hiranyakashipu is very happy. He is, what, again? Not only worship Vishnu, 9 ways we can worship Vishnu. Shavadam, Kirtanam, Svaranam, Padasana. And there are 9 people who are a perfection of that. Who is the perfection of Shavadam? You know, who is the perfection of Shavadam? Parikshit Maharaj. So. Who is the perfection of Kirtana? Huh? Shukadeva Goswami. Take care. Who is the perfection of Smarana? Prahlad Maharaj. Who is the perfection of Pada Sevana? Lakshmi. Who is the perfection of Archanam? Kya? Haan, wo Brahman Diksha mein tha kya? Paper mein, huh? Prithu Maharaj, Archanam. He worshipped the 4 Kumaras. Okay. Vandanam, who is the perfection of Vandanam? Huh? Akrura. Who is the perfection of Dasyam? Yes, Hanuman. And perfection of Sakya? Arjun. Who is the perfection of Atmanivedana? Bali Maharaj. Take the 9 people who are perfection of this each element. So Hiranyakashipu is, what is the nonsense? Just like for us, demon is a demon. For a demon, demigod is a demon. They don't like. What is this Vishnu nonsense? So he is very angry. Now he is very angry. And actually, this time, he throws, Prahlad Maharaj is sitting on his lap. And Hiranyakashipu embraced him. And tears come from the eye of Hiranyakashipu. Out of love. After that, he asks this question. And when Prahlad Maharaj gives his reply, 9 ways of bhakti, he takes Prahlad Maharaj and throws on the ground. You can see this. And he asked the teacher, Shanda and Amarka, "You nonsense." He says, "You nonsense, what are you teaching my son? Why are you teaching all these things to my son? Why are you spoiling the head of my son?" So he asked Prahlad Maharaj, so they say, we are not teaching. So he asked Shanda and Amarka, he asked Prahlad Maharaj, "Who taught you all this nonsense?" Then Prahlad Maharaj gives now 3 shlokas. Okay? Very, very important shlokas. Materina Krishna Parato Satova Mito Abhipadye de Grahavatana Adand Gobhi Vishatam Tamesham Puna Puna Charvita Charvananam. What is the meaning? It says, Materina Krishna. He says, "You will never become Krishna conscious, my father. You are asking me who made me Krishna conscious. That is not important to answer you. But I tell you something, you will not become Krishna conscious. Materina Krishna. Materina Krishna Parato Satova. Even though other people try to make you Krishna conscious, Swata, you try to become Krishna conscious. Or combined effort to become Krishna conscious. 3 ways you can become. Suppose teaching. I can teach you. You can yourself try. And all of us together try. Parato, Swato, Mitho. 3 ways. He said, no way you will become Krishna conscious. Why? Adanta gobihi. Because you are not controlling your senses. Vishatam tamishram. You are going into darkness of ignorance. And you are chewing what you have already chewed. So many times you have chewed sense gratification. It is frustrating. But you continue to do that. He has no anger for his father. He is instructing. He is an acharya with affection. My dear father, you will not become Krishna conscious unless you give up all these things. So then he continues. Nate vidu swarth gatim hi Vishnu durashaya ye bahi artamaninaha Andayatande upiniyamana tepishitantra murudamni baddaha. He says, Nati vidu swarth gati Vishnu. Nati vidu. People do not know the real interest is to surrender to Vishnu. Durashaya ye bahiyarthamanina. So much value they are giving to sense gratification. Bahi artha manina. So much value to sense gratification. Andhayatandai. They are blind and they are running after other blind people. Andha yathandai. Upaniyamana. The blind man is taking a blind man, so both will fall into a ditch. Tipi shitanta murudhamni baddaha. All of them are tightly bound by the laws of material nature. And then he says the final statement, a solution for the problem. He diagnosed the problem of his father, now he is telling a solution. Naisha matestava durukramangrim sparshati anartha upagamo yadartaha mahiyasam pada rajo abhishekam niskinchana nam navrinita yavat. He says, my dear father, if you can take the dust of the lotus feet of a pure devotee and put on your whole body, do abhisheka of that, that's the only way you can come out of this problem. So we are also in a problem like Hiranyakashipu. We have started surrender, but we are not fully surrender. We have just started surrender to Krishna. Surrender is a process. It is not one or zero. So we have just started surrender. So if what is blocking our complete surrender? We still have some Hiranyakashipu in our heart. So if we take shelter of a pure devotee, just like in ISKCON, Srila Prabhupada is our pure devotee. If we take a sincere shelter, shelter means to obey him and follow his instructions, then we can be saved from the material existence. So what happens to Hiranyakashipu now? After hearing four shlokas, he is wild. He is extremely angry. So much so, he says, you are teaching me to control the senses? He is always drunk. But he cannot see that. You know, that is his situation. He is always drunk. But he doesn't want to accept any instructions. But anyway, he becomes angry and tries to kill Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj doesn't take any offense any time. Just imagine, father is trying to kill the child and he is taking no offense. He is totally surrendered to Krishna. Okay? And rest everybody knows. So Prahlad Maharaj is a very great example. He continues to give wonderful instruction to his classmates after this. He makes all his classmates into wonderful devotees. And then finally, when his father brings a sword to kill him, Narasimhadeva saves him. And then Prahlad Maharaj offers two chapters of wonderful prayers to Narasimhadeva. So we should take advantage of all these instructions and advance the spiritual life. Prahlad Maharaj is our guru. He is only a 5-year-old boy, but he is our guru. Okay? We should take advantage of his instructions and advance the spiritual life.